school teacher trying to do the right thing, has black heroes posted in the classroom. I'm talking about people like, you know, Harriet Tubman, Colin Powell, George Washington Carver, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. The school decided to rip these pictures down and said it was inappropriate. Well, that teacher has resigned. Let's put up my hero of the week. This teacher in Florida, his name is Michael James, 61 years of age. He emailed Governor Ron DeSantis and the Escambia County Superintendent Tim Smith Monday night with his resignation. He resigned over what he characterized as racist behavior by a school district employee. And I agree with Mr. James. Mr. James is in a district where many of his students are what? African American. Let's get into it. He wrote that the district employee removed pictures of historic black American heroes, citing them as being, and I quote, age inappropriate. On Tuesday morning, he officially resigned as an exceptional student education teacher at O.J. Sims Elementary School. It was going to be his first year teaching in Florida. Well, see how that went. Images that were removed included the pictures of Dr. King and others. Let's put them up. Look at that. Look at that. According to the school that he was teaching in, these individuals are not heroes. These individuals are controversial. They are not appropriate. Mr. James told the Pensacola News Journal, it really floored me. I've been teaching special education for 15 years. And it just really floored me when she did that. James was employed to teach students ranging from kindergarten to fifth grade. James chose the board's theme because the majority of the students and the residents in the community are black. And he wanted to motivate his students with inspirational leaders they could easily look up to and see themselves in. That's how you do it. When I was a high school teacher, I did the same thing. There's more. This is how the incident unfolded. On Monday, the behavior analyst and another behavior coach entered his classroom to help him set up the room. This is kind of unusual, but that's okay, James recalled thinking. They came in and we started moving tables around and swapping some out. And I had made the bulletin board a couple of days earlier. So the black people are already there, all right? Bulletin board was directly behind his desk in front of the class, which is pretty atypical. It contained about 5 to 7 images of black historical figures, as well as the Pledge of Allegiance. The individual pictures were about the size of a piece of paper with short written passages on them explaining the achievements of each person. Mr. James said, and I quote, I was sitting down in one of the children's chairs cutting something out, and I turned around and saw her start taking something off the bulletin, Mr. James recalled. When he questioned what the behavioral analyst was doing, she said something along the lines of, it wasn't age appropriate, something like that, James said. Mr. James does not remember the woman mentioning race while taking down the photos, but he did not, but he did note that she had also seized a picture of former President Barack Obama that he placed near his desk because there wasn't room on the bulletin board. Now, please understand what's happening right here. Please understand what's happening. You have a black school district. You have a white educator who understands the necessity of students being able to see themselves in the leadership presented in front of them. My mother, the woman who adopted me, is still a school teacher today. She does the exact same thing every single year. I help her decorate that classroom every year. This is not abnormal. This is actually pretty normative, standard. That's why Mr. James said, I was shocked that they were doing this. There's more. She picked it up and said, you don't need to put this up either, James recalled. She said, I can't remember exactly what she said, but she said, the kids are too young or something like that. It floored me. I thought, This is the first black president. Oh, can I say something else to you, Mr. James? Not only was he the first black president, he was a president. Mm-hmm. See how that works? He was a president. She has literally told you, you cannot have a picture of a former president of the United States inside of your classroom. There's more. Let's go ahead and expose the superintendent. Put his picture up. Okay. Superintendent Tim Smith.
Is it rude to say that I predicted it?
Not rude, brother. But here's what's interesting. The way he decided to tackle this is interesting. The superintendent Tim Smith said teachers are permitted to decorate their classrooms with educational materials. He was unaware of any policies that would prohibit displaying pictures of inspirational American heroes. Smith said a full investigation of the incident, which he called an anomaly, has been launched. The district has yet to confirm the identity of the district employee. More details should come on why James resigned. I'm going to get to this superintendent in just a second, because his response seems right, but it's not. James said he could not work for a school under the umbrella of a school district that would hire people who would condone such behavior. I hate to say this about everybody in the staff or the leadership there, but something is not right. He said something needs to be changed or fixed. Mr. James, you are teaching in Florida, sir. Okay, you're teaching in Florida. These things happen in Florida to a tune higher than other states based on the reporting we've done recently. Now, let me say this about the superintendent. Put his picture back up. So the superintendent said all the right things in a prepared statement written by his communications director. Okay. Superintendent says, teachers can, they can decorate their own classrooms. I was unaware of any policy where teachers cannot do this. Understand the fake out that just happened. He focused on Mr. James rather than focusing on the awful and horrendous behavior of the behavioral analyst and the other district supervisor who was in the classroom. You see, the focus of his statement should have been antithetical to those two individuals rather than simply nodding and agreeing that Mr. James was correct or highlighting that the policy should not have allowed this to happen. How about you actually have a statement, not that you're investigating the incident, but you are in fact investigating the two people who did this deed and revealed their names because they are public servants. Mr. James, his name is exposed here. Expose the other people who were involved, Mr. Superintendent. So if you want to be right, let's do it all the way. Let's do it all the way, brother, because you are a superintendent over a school that has majority black students. This is your opportunity to show them you're not an ass. All right, Rick, thoughts?
White fragility is a serious thing, eh? I as I'm reading this, right, and as I'm going through this and I'm listening to you, the only thing I could think of is like, whose photo would be acceptable? Like,
I'm going to send my photo. Can I send my photo to the school?
You are more than welcome to send your photo. I don't think it'll be accepted.
I don't think so.
You know, my mind, a show favorite here, Doc. Herschel Walker. Is his photo acceptable? Is that something that the students should strive to be? Like, I'm super curious, like what would it take?
That's a great point.
I am curious, but like this also reminds me of a story that we covered on TYT Sports probably 2-3 years ago of a math teacher for like 20 plus years in Florida who put up a mural of Colin Kaepernick. And the calls that they received from parents forced this math teacher during Black History Month to tear down that mural. So like this isn't necessarily a new thing. It's more of the voices are being empowered because you have a governor who is passing stuff like the Stop Woke Act and the Don't Say Gay Bill. And what he's doing is empowering, much like Donald Trump, because hey, let's be real about this. He rode those coattails until he didn't need them because he made a name for himself.
That's right.
He is empowering the bullies. He is empowering these people to insert themselves in the students' criteria when they probably don't even know, you know, fifth grade algebra, but they will implore the schools to listen to them. We are empowering the wrong people. And I noticed, you know, in the Pensacola news article that there is a teacher shortage. It has been driven a lot by the parents.
Yep.
Much like youth sports. The parents are out of control. They are insane when it comes to this stuff. Now, very quickly, not only are they empowering, in my view, bigoted parents, because if you're getting mad, you know, at the pictures we saw, it says something to me about your character. But this is also a governor who, during the gubernatorial debate with Andrew Gillum, said to his constituents mainly, we can't monkey up this election. This is a guy who has spoken at very alt-right conservative seminars who have said, and their founders have said, that black people need to thank white people for freeing them. That's the company he keeps. And thus, with his constituency that looks up to him and votes for him, these are the results of him being in power.
Very well said.